हेलो एवरीवन, तो कैसे हैं आप लोग? आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल। ओके, सो अगेन वी स्टार्टेड फिजिक्स। ओके, सो टुडेस टॉपिक वी आर डिस्कसिंग हियर मोशन। दिस इज द साइंस टॉपिक ऑफ क्लास 9th। सो इन दिस टॉपिक व्हाट वी कवर, सो हियर वी हैव सम पॉइंट्स। ओके, फर्स्ट वी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट रेस्ट एंड मोशन, रेस्ट एंड मोशन। सेकेंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट स्केलर एंड वेक्टर क्वांटिटीज, स्केलर एंड वेक्टर। दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ मोशंस। ओके, सेकेंड टाइप्स ऑफ मोशंस, बिकॉज मोशंस आर इन वेरियस फॉर्म। ओके, थर्ड इज स्केलर एंड वेक्टर क्वांटिटीज। ओके, दोज आर फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज, स्केलर एंड वेक्टर। ओके, एंड फोर्थ डिफरेंस बिटवीन डिस्टेंस एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट। अगेन फिफ्थ डिफरेंस बिटवीन स्पीड एंड वेलोसिटी। सो दीज आर द पॉइंट वी आर डिस्कसिंग टुडे। ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर टेकिंग दिस पॉइंट, रेस्ट एंड मोशन। ओके, सो व्हाट आर द रेस्ट, व्हाट इज मोशन? सो वी हैव सम ऑब्जर्वेशन, बिकॉज ऑफ दिस ऑब्जर्वेशन वी कैन से द पर्टिकुलर ऑब्जेक्ट आर इन मोशन आर आर इन रेस्ट। सो हाउ कैन वी डिफाइन द ऑब्जेक्ट्स स्टेट्स, द पर्टिकुलर ऑब्जेक्ट इज इन रेस्ट आर इज इन मोशन। सो आई हैव दिस डस्टर, हैव यू सीन दिस डस्टर? ओके, नाउ आई प्लेस इट ऑन द टेबल। सो हाउ कैन वी से द पर्टिकुलर ऑब्जेक्ट इज इन विच स्टेट्स? So right now we can say the object is it in rest? It's my words, but in the physics how can we explain this is an object? So what is the definition of the rest, what are the definition of motion? So the definition of the rest is, if an object does not change their position with respect to surrounding with the passage of time. Okay, what I said to you, again I said to you, if an object does not change their position with respect to surrounding, here surrounding take the reference point, with the passage of time, if koi object apni position change nahi kara time ke sath, so we can say the particular object is in rest. Okay, so now you can see the raster, here you can see the raster, this raster can't change their position with respect to surroundings. Here surroundings, this green box, this tables, myself. Okay, with my respect, this duster is not change their position. So I can say the particular, this particular object ki baat karein, abhi iski baat karein, duster ka. So this duster is in a rest because it does not change their position with their surrounding with the passage of time. Time ke respect mein bhi time jata ja raha hai, uske sath sath iski position change ho rahi hai kya? Nahi ho rahi. So we can say the duster is in a rest. Okay, so what are the definition? So definition is, if an object does not change their position with their surroundings with the passage of time, that time the particular object is in a rest. Okay, clear? Okay, so what are the motion, what is the motion? Okay, so the definition of the motion is, if an object continuously change their position with their surroundings with respect to their surrounding with the passage of time. What I said to you guys, if an object continuously change their position with their surrounding with the passage of time, then we can say the object is in a motion. Okay, first we can take some observation. Okay, now I hold this water bottle. Okay, in this position, now again I place this water bottle in the on the table. So this water bottle does not change their position, so we can say the bottle is in a rest. Now what I do, now I hold this water bottle. Now, see the observation. This water bottle continuously change their position with respect to their surrounding. Yeah, surroundings jo hai. Ye hai reference point. So, first of all, we are taking the reference point. With the reference point, we can observe the distance of the object. Okay? Now, I take this duster as a reference point. See. Now, observe the distance of this water bottle and the duster. This water bottle and duster distance doesn't change. It means this object does not change their position with respect to their surrounding. Here I am taking reference point, this duster. So you can see or you can observe the distance. It changes or doesn't. So I can say it doesn't change their position. So this water bottle is in a rest. But now in this scenario, it's continuously changing their position with respect to duster. So in this case, I can say the water bottle is in a motion because it continuously changes their position with respect to duster. Okay? So from this observation, we can say that if an object continuously changes their position with respect to a fixed point taken as a reference point with the passage of time. Okay? Okay. So here you are understanding about the rest and motion. Okay? Clear? So next here types of motions. Okay? So we can see many types of motion in our surroundings. Just like this. This is the rolling motion. Okay? As well as this is the rectangular motion. So how can we describe the motions? Okay? So we have some types of motion just like rectilinear motion. Rectilinear motion. Second, curve. Circular motion, oscillatory motion, vibratory motion, variable motion. How can we define these types of motions? First, we take a rectilinear motion. So, if an object move from one point to another point in a straight line. Again, I said, if an object move from one point to another point in a straight line. Suppose this is the point A and this is the point B. If an object move from here to here in a straight line. So this straight line make a rectilinear line. So this types of motion known as rectilinear motion. If an object move in straight path from one point to another point. So this type of motion is called rectilinear motion. Now for the second, curvilinear motion. If an object move in curved path. What I said to you here? If an object continuously move in curved path. So that types of motion is called curvilinear, like this. From A to B. From here. Okay, now see some types of curves here. So this types of motion is called curvilinear motion. When an object moves from one point to another point in a variable curvilinear path. So this types of motion is called curvilinear motion. Now again, third, circular path. So in this case, if an object moves from one point to another point in a circular path, like this. This is the circular path. So this type of motion is called circular motion. Okay? Clear? Okay. Now Fourth is here, oscillatory motion. When an object continuously move to and from its mean position. What I said to here? I repeat here. When an object continuously move to and from its mean point, this type of motion of the object is called the oscillatory motion. Here we have some example. Here is the pendulum. Okay. So see the motion of pendulum. Okay. Here we have arm of the pendulum. Okay. So I place it here. Okay, and release it. What you can see? This pendulum move from here towards to the mid position and move from here. Okay, so this pendulum continue to and fro from its mean position. This is the mean position of mean point of this pendulum. So this pendulum continues move from to and fro from its mean position. So this type of motion is called oscillatory motion. Okay, from A to B, this is C point. This C point is your main point. So continue this pendulum move to and fro. So this type of motion is called oscillatory motion. Now vibratory motion. If some object continuously move to and fro in a rectilinear path, what I said to you, if an object continuously move to and fro from its mean position in a rectilinear path, so this type of motion is called vibratory motion. So what changing here? Okay, this is the mean point and this is the path. Okay, now where is this? Okay, this is the point A, this is the point B, and this is point C. Okay, if an object can be moved to and fro in a straight line, so this type of motion is called vibratory motion. Okay, and this is variable motion. So we can see the object having more than one motion at the same time. So this type of motion is called variable motion. Just like we can throw the ball. So you have seen the curvilinear motion as well. It's move on about their own axis. Okay, balls move about their own axis as well as moving with the curvilinear path. So ball has two types of motion. One is the curvilinear motion, another one is the rotatory motion, because it's move about their own axis. If an object move about their own axis, this type of motion is called oscillatory motions. Okay, rotatory motions. If an object continuously rotate their about own axis, this type of motion is called rotatory. We are not mentioning a rotatory motion, but is the kind of the motion. So that particular time when I throw the ball, okay, the ball has two types of motion. One is the curvilinear motion, because this ball moving like this in the curve form. Okay, and it's move about their own axis like this. Like this on their about their own axis. So ball has two types of motion. One is the rotatory motion, because it's rotate about their own axis. Second is curvilinear motion, because it's moving curved path. So particular time they have two types of motion. So this type of motion of object is called variable motion. Okay, so here you can see types of the motion. First, rectilinear motion. If an object moves in a straight path, that type of motion is called rectilinear motion. Curvilinear motion, when object moves in curvilinear path or curved path, so that type of motion is called curvilinear motion. Circular motion, if an object continues to move about their fixed point. Okay, when an object moves around their fixed point. Okay, so this type of motion is called circular motion. Okay, oscillatory motion, when an object continues to and fro from its mean position. So this type of motion is called oscillatory motion. Variable motion, vibratory motion, when an object can be to and fro from its motion in a rectilinear path. So this type of motion is called vibratory motion. Variable motion, if an object having more than one motion. So this type of motion of the object is called variable motions. So here you are understanding about the types of motion. Okay, so now we are going to physical quantities. Okay, now I am erasing this. Okay, so how we can define the physical quantity, types of physical quantity? So we have two types of physical quantity in the physics. Okay, so one is the scalar quantity. So first of all, we are discussing about the scalar quantity as well as vector quantity. So here physical quantity, which are scalar quantity. Scalar quantity. What are the scalar quantity in physics? A physical quantity which are completely described by their magnitude only. These types of physical quantity known as scalar quantity, just like distance, speed, time, temperature, area, volume, and so on. Okay, so these types of physical quantity known as scalar quantity because they are completely described by their magnitude only. Okay, now so time to vector quantity. Which types of physical quantity known as vector quantities? Okay, now vector quantity. The physical quantity which are completely described by their magnitude as well as direction. वो physical quantity इसको describe करने के लिए magnitude के साथ साथ direction की जरूरत भी होती है. This types of physical quantities known as vector quantities. Just like displacement, velocity. Acceleration, force, friction, and so on. Okay, so this has a physical quantity known as vector quantity because this quantity is described by their magnitude as well as direction. How can we describe their direction? We will learn later on. Okay, so you have to understanding the basic concept of the scalar quantity and vector quantity. Those quantity completely described by their magnitude only. This types of physical quantity known as scalar quantity, and those physical quantity completely described by their magnitude as well as direction. So this types of physical quantity known as vector quantity. So here we have some scalar and vector quantities like distance and displacement. We will discussing how they are the scalar quantities and how they are in vector quantities. Okay. So here we are discussing about the distance and displacement. Okay, I will take chalk here. Okay. First of all, we are discussing about distance. What is distance? The actual length of the path covered by an object in a given interval of time. Okay? The actual length of the path covered by an object in a given interval of time. If an object covered distance from A to B, from here to here. So this is the actual length of the path. So this path is called distance covered by the object. It means an object moved from one point to another point, and the distance length covered by an object is called distance covered. Okay, so from here to here, suppose this is the 1.2 kilometer. So what is the distance covered by the object from 1 to point B, from A to B? Okay, how many distance is covered? 1.2 kilometer. So this is the actual length of the path this is the actual length of the path. So this is the distance. Okay, distance के लिए direction use नहीं होगी. Clear है? So this distance is a scalar quantity. Okay, because distance को हम सिर्फ magnitude के through ही completely describe कर सकते हैं. So this distance is a scalar quantity. We know it to describe with the help of direction. So this distance is scalar quantity. Suppose I am going from point A to point B. This is the point B. This is the point. After that, I am going to point C. This is. Suppose the distance between them. This is the 5 km, and this is 6 km. So this total length of the path is 11 km. What is the total length of the path is 11 km. How this 5 km plus this 6 km. Okay, total 11 km. So total length covered by the object from A to B and B to C is 11 km. This is the actual length covered by the object. So this actual length is called distance. Okay. Now going to the displacement. Okay, so what is displacement? Okay, the shortest distance point between initial point to final point is called displacement. The shortest distance between initial point to the final point covered by the object is called displacement. Suppose an object is take point A, okay, and it travel from 1 to A to B, from here to here. So the shortest distance between them is this straight line. So this is the displacement for this object, but this is the actual path. So it is also a distance, but again it's moved from here to point C. Okay, suppose this is distance 5 km and this is 4 km. Okay, so here it is the distance 5 + 4 is 9 km. But what about the displacement? In the definition I told you, the total distance between initial point to final point. What is the initial point? Initial point is A. And what is the final point? Final point is C. So what is the displacement? So from here to here. Okay. The total distance between initial point to final point in a particular direction. In which direction? From A to C. So this length is called displacement. This is the distance. And this is displacement. The shortest distance between initial point A to final point C in the particular direction from A to C. Here you can see the direction from A to C. And what about the distance? First A to B, this is, and B to C. But in the displacement direct 1 to A to C. Okay. So here we need to direction to describe the displacement. So displacement is the vector quantity. Okay, suppose I am taking a curvilinear path like this. Suppose I am staying here, point A, and I want to move another, my office or school, point B, but not instead of like this path. Okay, so what is the distance and what are the displacement? Both are the same in this case? No, definitely, because this length is distance. The actual path length is distance. But what about the displacement? Okay, the straight line between initial point to final point in a particular direction from A to B. Okay, so this is the distance only. Okay, this is the actual path of the length. So this is the distance. What about displacement? The straight line from the initial point to final point from A to B is called displacement. Okay, the shortest distance between initial point, this is the initial point, to final point. The shortest distance between initial point to final point. Okay. So this is the distance and this is the displacement. Distance के लिए direction की जरूरत नहीं हो रही, यहाँ पर direction vary कर रही है. Here you can see the direction is vary in the distance. But in case this is the straight line, यहाँ पर direction एक particular direction आपको provide की है. So displacement needs direction. So displacement is a vector quantity. We can describe the distance as well as displacement here. Okay. So do you understand about the distance? What is the difference between distance and displacement? We can describe by the different perspective. For the distance, we need only magnitude. For the displacement, we need magnitude as well as direction. Okay. Magnitude here. Suppose this is the length. This is the 2 kilometers. This length is up to 3 kilometers. So here you can see the difference between the magnitude. Okay, distance 3 kilometers, displacement 2 kilometers. So from this observation, we can say the distance always equal and more than displacement. Distance always equal and more than. Suppose an object move in straight path like this. So what about the distance? What about the displacement? In this case, both are the same. This is the actual path of length. Okay, this is the distance and this is also displacement. The initial point to final point. The shortest distance between initial point to final point. Okay, so this is the distance as well as distance. Both are the same in this case. But what about in this case? What about in this case? Distance is more than displacement. Okay? जो actual length है path की वो क्या है? ज्यादा है किससे? Displacement से. क्योंकि displacement में क्या होता है? सबसे छोटी distance होती है जो कि initial point से final point के लिए होती है. Okay? So here you understood about the difference between distance and displacement. Okay. Again, we take some another observation about distance and displacement. Okay, suppose if I am moving on the circular path, if I am moving in circular path, suppose I am here, I am moving on this path. Suppose I am moving to this office. This is my office. Okay, this is my office. So I am going to this from this path. Suppose the length of this path is 10 kilometers. Okay? I am traveling 10 kilometers. So what is the distance? Total distance kitni ho jayegi yahan par? 10 kilometers. But what about distance? This is the displacement. Okay? From point A to point B. This is the displacement. Okay? If I come back from another way, from here to here, again come back my home. So what is distance covered by me and what is the distance total displacement covered by me in this case? So total distance, suppose this is also 10 kilometer. This is also 10 kilometer. Okay. So what are the distance, total distance covered by me? 10 kilometer as well as 10 kilometer. So total distance covered by me 20 kilometers. And what about the displacement? What about the displacement? So here you can see the initial point and final point are at the same place. So displacement is zero. What about the displacement? Zero, because the initial point and final point both are same. Are you getting what I said to you? The initial point and final point both are the at same place. So distance पे ही नहीं, displacement क्या है? Zero. But what about the distance? Distance is 20 kilometer. 10 kilometer from this side and 10 kilometer from this side. ऐसे क्या होगा? Rectangular path में ऐसा हो सकता है. Suppose I am moving from this path to here and again back from here. So distance 5 plus 5, 10 kilometer. Suppose this distance is 5 kilometer. If I am moving from point A to B and B to A. So in this case, what is the distance? What are the displacements? Okay, so distance 10 plus 5 plus 5, 10 kilometer I thought. But what about displacement? Both are the same place. So displacement is 0. So from this observation we can say the distance always more than or equal than displacement. Distance always positive. Distance always positive, but displacement may be positive, may be negative or zero as well. ओके जब हम साइन कन्वेंशन लेंगे तो उसमें अपन को पता चलेगा कि डिस्प्लेसमेंट नेगेटिव कैसा होता है पॉजिटिव कैसा होता है. सपोज दिस इज द साइन कन्वेंशन एज यू नो अबाउट दिस दिस इज द मेन पॉइंट. ओके दिस इज द एक्स एक्सिस दिस इज द वाई एक्सिस. ओके ओके दिस इज द वाई डैश दिस इज एक्स डैश. ओके फ्रॉम दिस साइड वी टेक पॉजिटिव फॉर द एक्स. फ्रॉम अपवर्ड वी टेक पॉजिटिव वैल्यूज ऑफ वाई. This side we take negative value of y. From this side we can take negative of value of x. Okay. Suppose object move from here to here. So here we can see the distance. Suppose this is the 5 kilometer. So in the x direction we travel 5 kilometers. So total distance is 5 kilometer. I come back 7 kilometer. So this is the minus 2 kilometer. Okay. So in this case, how many distance I am covered here? 5 plus 7. Total 5 plus 7 is equal to 12 kilometer. Okay. But what about the displacement? What about the displacement in this case? So we are started from here. So in this path, straight path. So I am covered 5 kilometer displacement. But come back at there. Okay. This is the zero displacement. But in case this the value is negative here. So नेगेटिव वैल्यू कितना है माइनस टू. सो व्हाट अबाउट द डिस्प्लेसमेंट माइनस टू किलोमीटर. इन विच डायरेक्शन दिस इज द नॉर्थ दिस इज द ईस्ट साउथ दिस इज द वेस्ट. इन द वेस्ट साइड टू किलोमीटर इन वेस्ट साइड. ओके सो फ्रॉम दिस साइड कैंसिल वी कैन टेक हाउ पॉजिटिव negative as well as zero. If I take 5 kilometer this side and come back 5 kilometer, so total distance covered by me 10 kilometer. But what about displacement? Displacement may be zero, absolute zero, maybe nahi rahega, absolute zero. But in this case value is negative. In this case value become negative. So from this observation we can say the objects displacement in negative. Okay, from sign convention we can observe this completely things. Okay, again we are going to the speed. From next lecture we are discussing about the speed and velocity and acceleration. Okay, from today's this is the enough for you all. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.